stop me, 'cause I'm having a good time, having a good time. I'm a shooting star, leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car, passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go, 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 there's no stopping me.
Hey everybody, due to the time limits and just life, I guess, I'm gonna have to make this review quick and just do it audio. I'm really sorry this review is gonna have to be just rushed and stuff, but, life is, but anyway, Fast 5. This is the fifth installment of the Fast and Furious franchise, and in this one, Brian O'Connor and, Dominic Toretto, played by Paul Walker and Vin Diesel, are now running from the law, and they're hiding out in Rio de Janeiro. And they have to pull this last job to steal the money of this big Rio bad guy or whatever. On the way, they're being chased by Dwayne Johnson, who's a federal agent. This is probably going to be my weakest review, but just life is. But anyway, everybody's been saying, oh, this movie's great and stuff, but, I'm not insulting them or anything, but honestly speaking, I didn't like it. I don't see why I didn't. This is my kind of movie. Just fun popcorn dude movie, you know, explosions, cars, guns, hot chicks, everything. But just, I don't know, I didn't like it. I mean, not that it was enjoyable, definitely. I mean, there's parts I really enjoyed. I mean, I thought the acting for the movie, for the kind of movie it was decent. I thought, you know, especially Dwayne Johnson, he was really, really good, and I'm just so glad to see him in action movies. I thought, you know, Justin Lin did a great job directing the action, a still camera, no shaky cam. I thought the action was extremely entertaining when it was actually there, and I thought the humor was actually really good, especially when it was delivered by Tyrese and Ludacris. But overall, I mean, after thinking about it, I walked out trying to see what I actually thought of the movie, because I was really unsure. And 10 minutes later, this is a true story, I realized I'd forgotten everything except for the action and, like, the humor. Oh, and also the guy who played Han was really good. I expected all the, you know, bad plot, bad writing, you know, not well-developed characters. I expected that, so I'm not even complaining about that. Don't think I'm being snobbish. It's just, I don't know, the movie's too long, and it just feels drawn out. Whenever there was an action, it was boring me, to be honest. I thought there should have been a lot more action, but it just didn't have a good enough story or anything to carry those scenes where there was an action. I mean, you know, like I said, it didn't bring my brain into this movie. I knew it was going to be stupid, but I don't know. It was just 5.5 out of 5. I know, ironic, this fifth one. I thought it was enjoyable, definitely, but just, I don't know. I'd watch it again, actually, on TV, but I didn't like it, guys, but, yeah, sorry this review's just really messed up and stuff, but live, I just had to get this in, but I won't be able to do it tomorrow. I don't have much time tonight, so, my review of Thor is gonna be up either Friday night or Saturday morning. It won't be like this, I, you know, promise, and, until next time, guys. You know, I'm Alan Gunn here too. What's crap and what's not.